Well, Yellen's comments certainly bound to give some lift to sentiment this part of the world. Joining me live to talk more from Singapore is Tony Nash. He is the chief economist and managing partner at Complete Intelligence. Tony, there you have it. The Fed's laid out a long laundry list of conditions to watch for before they can hike again. The dollar can't appreciate further. Commodity prices have to stabilize. Housing sector has to contribute more to the economy. How are you reading all of this?
Well, certainly it looks like there's going to be a lag before we start to see rising rates in the U.S. It looks like there's more of an enablement of risk appetite for things like emerging markets and commodities. So I'd look for a bit of a bounce back there as well as places like Japan.
Has this pushed out your own expectations of the next rate hike?
Sure, yeah. We didn't think there would be a rate hike this month. We thought June would be the soonest, but after her comments, we're thinking it might actually be September before we start to see some activity.
So not till the third quarter of the year. Tony, one thing we've seen play out in the markets again and again this year is a rush into safe haven assets. I mean, of course, you're talking Japanese bonds and the yen and gold and the euro to a certain extent. I mean, all of that is bound to ease off a little bit given Yellen's comments. But is this much volatility at the start of the year normal? I mean, from what you've seen over the years?
No, it's not normal. And what we've been saying is, you know, Q1, we've expected it to be volatile. We'll see things moderate in Q2. And the second half of the year should be a bit more tame than we've seen in the first quarter. So, you know, what you've seen is a lot of reaction around a strong dollar. And now that the dollar is weakening, you'll start to see lower volatility around commodities, lower volatility around the yen, as Mr. Kuroda's aims and Janet Yellen's aims align. You've seen some organization with the NPC in China as more fiscal stimulus is going in China. And so there's a clearer path, and people are starting to see a clearer path in the States and in this part of the world as to kind of the economies coming together and moving in the same direction. The Fed has been kind of the most hawkish central bank, or one of the most hawkish central banks out there. So with these comments from Yellen, the Fed just starts to slightly align with the dovishness of most central banks globally.
Right. But this outlook on a tamer second half of the year, where is this coming from?
Well, there are base effects. You know, you've had things like commodities fall. Commodities fell 30% between, say, the end of May and early December. And it continued to fall through December and January. So, you know, you have base effects, which will give the perception of stabilization. But you also have capitulation, and what you'll start to see in energy markets is capitulation around things like upstream activity, say production or asset sales, that sort of thing, that will translate into capitulation through the channel in commodities. You're starting to see capitulation other aspects of commodities, and so that means investors, that means asset owners are kind of surrendering to the overall market. The big question we've had for the last 18 months is, where is the demand? Okay, you just don't see demand growth in most of the world, and this is the biggest issue with things like commodities, with currencies and other things, and exports as well. The value of global exports declined by 14% in 2015. So demand has evaporated, and we're just not seeing traction in global growth and country-level growth.
Right.
And so
exports.
This is the key issue, is the search for demand.
Absolutely. Exports has been a big a bugbear for a lot of these countries. But just very quickly, Tony, when you look at what's happening across the world, are you more comfortable buying or selling at this stage?
Obviously, it's a very tactical situation. I don't think you can make a global macro play and say, sell everything, buy everything. I think there's a temporary opportunity with the declining dollar and with the accommodative Fed. So that presents a lot of opportunities with some currencies and certainly with emerging markets.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Thank you very much, Tony, for your perspective.